everything about Modern Warfare 2's intervention was satisfying, and it had a massive impact on both first-person shooters and YouTube gaming videos, as the site was... We focus a lot on FPS games and third-person shooters on this channel, and there have been tons and tons of guns in various video games. You've got big guns, small guns, explosive guns, you guys know the drill. But what are those guns that somehow manage to be extra cathartic and super satisfying when you beat someone with it? What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Today, we are going to be taking a look at my 10 personal picks of the most satisfying video game guns of all time. So be sure to let me know in the comment section which one is your favorite, or if I missed your favorite gun, drop it in there. Drop a like, make sure you're subscribed, turn on those post notifications, and away we go. Kicking things off today is the iconic and over-the-top firearm from the legendary multiplayer shooter, Quake 3 Arena. I'm talking about none other than the powerful hitscan weapon known as the Railgun. This thing will fire a juicy energy round and it will immediately deal 100 damage to whoever it hits. It kills any unarmed enemy in a single shot. And the Railgun has a pretty long cooldown time and an overall slow rate of fire. It makes it a very, very high risk, but very high reward weapon. And there are a few things as satisfying as jumping around a Quake map, lining up a shot, and getting an insta-kill with the Railgun. I think it's the perfect way to kick off today's list. At number 9, the Spartan Laser in Halo 3. Now, Halo has tons of awesome weapons, and Bungie clearly had a lot of fun coming up with all the futuristic tech for you to go crazy with, and one of the biggest standouts was indeed the Spartan Laser, which was first introduced in Halo 3. This massive anti-tank weapon was a charged shot energy launcher that would fire a huge red beam, traveling at a whopping 983 million feet per second, yes, right, and absolutely decimating anything it came in contact with. The Spartan Laser would kill any enemy in a single hit. If you hit a vehicle with it, it would instantly blow up. It killed anybody inside it or around it or in the vicinity. It was insanely powerful in both single player and multiplayer. There are a few things as satisfying in Halo 3 as grabbing the Spartan Laser, which is huge, lining up a shot on someone in a Pelican or a Warthog, and sending all the passengers flying when you pulled the trigger. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with post notifications on so you always get alerted when a new video goes up and you can get that elusive first comment. Next up is the Nasher shotgun in Gears of War. Iconic is one word to say about this shotgun from the third-person shooter franchise Gears, and when Gears was first released, it quickly made a name for itself with its very unique shooting mechanic and over-the-top blood and gore, much of which could be achieved with this shotgun. It was your sidearm throughout the campaign, as well as one of your starting weapons in the multiplayer. The Nasher was a double-barrel, lever-action shotgun that could carry 8 shells at a time, and it had insane stopping power. And up close, it could blow arms and legs clean off. It was a gibbing machine, and if you hit someone in the head, well, you would get that iconic Gears headshot sound effect as their skull exploded. Now, getting a one-shot kill with the Nasher is extremely satisfying in all the Gears games, and I think it's a good one to put on this list. Now let's go back to maybe a gun that you guys aren't familiar with. Maybe some of you are. Let me know if you are. The Cerebral Bore in Turok 2. Raise your hand if you remember Turok 2 at all. It was a sci-fi FPS genre involving a lot of guns and a ton of dinosaurs, developed by Acclaim Studios up until their bankruptcy in 2002. This is when the series kind of fell apart, and it's pretty much dead now. But Turok 2 is considered by many to be one of the best FPS games of all time. It was released for the N64 in late 1998. It had you playing as a dinosaur hunter with advanced weaponry, setting out to put a stop to a race of aliens who have created a world where time is meaningless and dinosaurs have started to walk again. Now, there are a ton of awesome weapons in Turok 2, one of which was a launcher called the Cerebral Bore. This thing would fire off explosive drills that would lock onto the enemy's head, hunt them down, start drilling, and then blow up once they got to the brain. It was crazy. It was powerful, it was super satisfying to watch, and part of me kind of hopes Turok will get a revival soon, but I kind of doubt it. Some of the games have been remastered and re-released in recent years, but I do not see a full-fledged reboot coming anytime soon, which is unfortunate. Next up is the hand cannon in Resident Evil 4. RE4 is a game all about being smart with your weaponry. You have to know what the guns take. I mean, you have to know how to manage your inventory and how to be smart with your ammo consumption. But that's not to say there isn't room for having a little bit of fun. The hand cannon is a magnum revolver that has to be unlocked by completing the Mercenaries minigame with 5 stars with all 5 characters, so it's a bit of a grind. But once you unlock it, you'll be able to bring it with you on your next story playthrough, and it has a massive hitbox and ridiculous power. It kills almost anything in one shot, and having the ability to take down multiple foes at once without losing any of its strength, it's worthy. It is definitely worthy of burning through all those challenges. At number 5, the pump shotgun in Fortnite. Now, the pump has seen quite a few changes throughout Fortnite's lifespan, and it was even pulled out of the game for a while during Season 9 for reasons that I still don't fully understand, but even if there may be a statistically better shotgun in the game, there's no denying how satisfying the pump is. It's the only shotgun in the game that will deal a clean 200 damage to the head, making it one of the only guns in that game that can actually one-shot a full-shielded enemy. It used to be, it completely shaped the meta of Fortnite. While it isn't quite as central of a focus now, it's still heavily used by Fortnite players and it's kind of wiggled its way into the current meta. Personally, I still way prefer the pump shotgun to the combat shotgun, and spamming shots just, to me, isn't as satisfying as lining one up and getting that clean 200 damage pop-off. But then again, I'm not a very good shot, so maybe I should just stick with spamming shots. At number 4, the Deagle, the Desert Eagle in CSGO. Over the last decade or so, the Deagle has become one of the most recognizable firearms in pop culture, and that is largely due to its addition in games like Call of Duty, Battlefield, and Counter-Strike. But if there's one version of the Deagle that rises above the rest, I think it's the CSGO version, which is the single strongest pistol you can get and also one of the most powerful guns in the game, period. Carries 7 shots, will deal a juicy 50 base damage at close or mid-range, makes it a 2-shot kill to the body, 1-shot kill to the head. And let me tell you, people really take advantage of this gun's 1-shot headshot potential. They do. One-shotting someone with the Deagle is one of the most satisfying things you can do in Counter-Strike, and it's become a staple of the community. It's not uncommon at all to see people running around with the Deagle as their primary weapon, just going for headshots and absolutely dumping on people with it. It is tough to get used to and definitely not easy to use, but if you know what you're doing, it's one of the most intimidating weapons in the game. Speaking of intimidating, the Intervention in Modern Warfare 2, and I'm sure plenty of you knew it was going to be on here, it redefined what sniping was in multiplayer shooters. Now, quick scoping was possible and somewhat prominent in COD 4 and World at War, but things got exploded in Modern Warfare 2 when Infinity Ward cranked everything up to 11, and that included the sniping. The Intervention was the only bolt-action rifle in the game and arguably the best sniper rifle, period, so people flocked to it and they loved it. Call of Duty was changed forever. The firing sound, the animations, the hitmarker sound, the sound of getting your killstreaks, everything about Modern Warfare 2's Intervention was satisfying, and it had a massive impact on both first-person shooters and YouTube gaming videos as the site was flooded with people uploading their Intervention montages. At number 2, the Kar98K in PUBG. PUBG has seen a ton of guns, and everybody has their own favorites. You guys can let me know what yours is. But if there's one gun that everything else beats in terms of satisfaction you get from doing well with, it's this one. The bolt-action sniper rifle has been in warfare for decades, first being adopted in the service by the German army in the 30s, and since has become a staple for World War II-themed movies and games. The Kar98K in PUBG is one of the best guns in the game for long-range combat. It boasts a base damage of 79 with a bullet travel speed of 760 meters per second. It will kill any enemy with a single headshot unless they're wearing a level 3 helmet, in which case it will still only take 2 shots to drop them, and sniping in PUBG is tough. But if you had a choice as to what you're going to be using for your long-range engagements, I'm willing to bet the majority of PUBG players will take the Kar. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with post notifications on so you always get alerted when a new video goes up and you can get that elusive first comment. And at number 1 today, the Super Shotty in Doom. No doubt in my mind, this is the most satisfying gun in video game history. The Super Shotgun is an iconic double barrel shotgun that first appeared in Doom 2. It was one of the best guns in the game. It would fire very slowly due to it needing to be reloaded after each trigger pull, but those shots, they hit hard, my friends, and following its popularity in Doom 2, the Super Shotgun was brought back in Doom 3 and Doom 2016, being one of the best guns in all of its appearances. You know, it's already confirmed to be making a return in Doom Eternal, and judging by the early gameplay, it's looking like it may be the best version to date. From the iconic design to the insane stopping power and awesome animations, the Super Shotgun from the Doom series is my pick for the most satisfying gun in video game history. And there you have it, my friends. Let me know where I got it right Let me know where I got it wrong. There are so many guns in video game history. I know you can throw some in here that definitely were deserving of making it. They just didn't make it on my list. If you guys enjoyed, check out the playlist below with all the other video game top 10s, and I'll see you soon.